Hi, my name is Veronica with Wreaths by Veronica, and today I'm here to show you how to make a Easter centerpiece with a bunny ears and feet attachment. So before we get started here, I just want to show you all the tools that you would need to get started with this project. And I hope your day was great. It's Monday, so I say, well, I did one yesterday. Let me do one again today. I'm feeling boosted up. So here are the tools that you would need. First of all, you would need a 10-inch work frame wreath right here with the tinsel ties in it. Again, like I stated before, if your budget doesn't allow you to buy these, you can just buy the wired rib and attach chenille stems on them. So you would need one of those. You would need a 10-inch mesh. I use four types. I use a green, a pink, four colors rather, a white, and a yellow. And what we'll be doing today is the curly loop technique. And also you would need ribbon, and this is the ribbon that I've chosen for this project. This one here, isn't it gorgeous? And also I chose denim. And of course we need some ribbon with some bunnies on it. Also, I chose this one. It's beautiful with the colors in it. It has the green, the yellow, and the pink. And that'll work well with that. Okay, and also, after we attach everything, we're going to need some Easter eggs. We're going to put Easter eggs inside it. So, to save with time, what I've done, I already put the mesh on. This is the 10-inch. So, you can imagine how big it's going to be afterwards. And we'll measure it afterwards. So what we're going to do now, we're going to go over cutting our ribbon. I always use wired ribbon. So I'm going to cut some. I left a couple of pieces so I can cut and you guys can see how we cut the ribbon. Again, we're going to together. And we cut along here. And that's how you get that V. As in Veronica. Okay, again, right here. The V. Isn't it beautiful? Along the side, cut. On the side, cut. Great. So I think those are all it. So how your day going? I hope you had a wonderful Monday. Mine was good. Can't complain about it. No sense in complaining about it. We just move forward and pray about it and just thank God he gave us another day. And we do know that joy do comes in the morning. So here's another one right here. Right here. Again, I'm from Houston, Texas. So if you out there, you watch my video, and you're from somewhere else, let me know. And please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Again, I'm Veronica by Wreaths by Veronica. I do wreaths as well, as I'm getting ready now to show you how to put together a Easter centerpiece. I also do embroidery as well as I do vinyl designs, and I do also baskets. So I have some videos on things that I do. So take a look at it. And get started. Let's get started. I dropped a couple of ribbons. I'm going to show you how to do this. This technique is called the curly technique. So what you do, you just, I cut it in 12 inches. This is a 10 inch mesh and you cut it in 12 inches. You just roll it up, curl it in, the curly loop technique. There it is, curly right there. And that's how you do, and you roll them all up, you get them all together, and you balling them up just like this, and then you put them inside your ties. Let's get started. I'm gonna start with this denim one, and I cut the ribbon 12 inches and paired those two together. Put it in the middle. Again, what we're gonna do is we're gonna open it completely up. And put it right down there on the all the way in, tie it down. I would do four times on this one, because we are done with putting in the curly loop, so we don't have to worry about opening it up again. And for this project, I'm afraid I didn't tell you, but you would need a rotary cutter. Please forgive me of that. I just don't want the video to run over. I did one yesterday and it was extremely long, and I hate that happened. And it was my first one, so I'm going to get better as I go. You also need some scissors, and you would need an awl. This is called an awl, because what we're going to do is put holes in the egg like that to puncture the hole in where it won't be too big. Okay, what we're going to do is alternate the ribbon strips, fold in the middle, I have it on top of box, so I hope you guys can see a little bit better than the other video. Trying to get better. So I will give me one of those tripod stands for my camera, but when I get the opportunity to, right at this time it's not an opportunity, so I'm gonna use what I have, and this is why I'm just going on with what I have and go from there. How about that? And if you could tell somebody about me on YouTube and have them to subscribe to my YouTube channel as well. And if you have any question, please feel free to leave comments down and I will answer them as soon as I can. Remember what we're going to do. We're going to go to the, open it up, lay it down. We're going to do it four times. Like I said, sometimes I do five to make sure it's all cinched down. Four is good. So, and this is how it's looking, guys, with that denim. And it doesn't matter if you start at the top or at the lower part. It doesn't matter. It's your preference, because it's your reef, and all reefs are beautiful to me. You created it, so it's beautiful. think what we do is turn the shake the ribbons out, and they won't break or tear. These here also came from a Trendy Tree. The denim and the rabbit came from Trendy Tree. Just good material. So we're gonna do it again. Fold, go in. Excuse me, allergies. We've been having rain out here, and you know, soon before we know it's gonna be allergy season because of the pine and all that. Because I have a lot of pine trees in my yard, and that, I'm telling you, that pine be falling and it's irritating. But I will not cut the trees down because it keeps the sun from just bogging down on the house so bad. Okay, again, right here, I'm gonna put it together. I hope I cut enough ribbon strips. If you haven't noticed the reef behind me, this is the tutorial, the spring reef I did last night. So it's finished. If anyone wants to purchase, you can leave a comment or go on my Facebook. It's listed, it's over there. Facebook.com. Reefs by Veronica. So remember, I'm on Facebook, Instagram, Pinterest. I also have an Etsy shop. Remember, we will leave these long until we get ready to use them. This here is completely full. I love that. What I'm gonna do is bring this box down because it's a little high for me to reach up. Okay, you're gonna undo it. Put it all the way down because you want to undo it. Because, like I stated, you don't want it to be stacked up. Okay. I hope you guys had a wonderful weekend. Something is sticking on my hand like I have tape or something on my hand. Because I was messing with some tape earlier. So you know how you get that tape that be on there. And you can bring this up just like this. You don't have to be afraid of it because like I stated, mesh is very forgiving, and it'll do whatever you put it at, it'll just turn and do. Also ribbon as well. Yeah, we're getting ready for that spring and Easter and all that good stuff. So, getting ready for that, and kids gonna be out on spring break, and look like they just went back from over here with Harvey, and also we have that ice freeze, so they was out again a couple of days. Right after Martin Luther King holiday. Another one, gonna open it up. Do four times. It really sits up high, guys. You noticing that? I love that. So just imagine that on your dining table for Easter, or you can have it for your decoration. You know, if you have your Easter dinner, you can put it there. I just love crafting. Any one of you guys have anything that you really enjoy doing besides working? Do you do anything for fun? You know, we have some people that like to do art. They love to paint. Some people love to do decorate their home, do decorating that. Some people love to garden. Now, that's one thing I didn't get into is gardening. I guess because I'm just afraid of bugs. And I just didn't want to do it. I think I just would drop everything. So, and I'm like, no, I don't like that. Because, I don't want no bug on me. I think that's my problem. I just don't like to do that. And some people garden, you know, they like to plant stuff. Because a lot of my coworkers have gardens. They be coming back with nice grapefruit, oranges, and all that, bananas, and jalapeno peppers. I mean, they really are into it. It's actually good too. I just thank them for sharing it. I also have some of my coworkers, they farmers as well. They have chickens and they have eggs. And I know I had a coworker one time, she had bees, and she was doing honey, and it was pure honey, so you know it really was good. It really was. I enjoyed that honey. I guess I did match out. That denim bringing it out though, that blue. And that denim, it really brings it out. It's nice. Okay, got the ribbon in. I'm adjusted as we go. But right now, I'm going to put in the attachment. So just trying to find out. I want you guys to see how beautiful that is. This is a 10 inch. And so let's bring out the bunny ears. So what I did down here, I put in some tinsel ties in there so we can grab that in there. I put about three going across this way and one going this way and one going that way. So we just put the bunnies in, the ears in. And this here I got last year, and I just never had the opportunity to make it. And I said, well, you know what, I can do a tutorial on that. That'll be great. See, I missed one, and that happens. I can fix that because it's so bundled up. But I like that. What do you think, guys? Isn't that cute? I love it. So right now I'm just gonna attach it in and turn it over to grab. So what I'm going to do is for the bottom, because I didn't want the ears just to sink down. I want them to have a little leverage where they're sit up. Yeah, it's looking great. Not gonna attach it all the way. And these do bend, so we can do that. And now we're gonna put the paws in. Okay, I want to show you. So at the end, at the bottom, I'm going to put this under there. That way it won't show. And the reason why I was looking at this, because I'm trying to think of the felt. I'm going to put some felt at the bottom. And it will be white. Probably white. It depends on how it look. So now I'm going to put the feet in. With a little paws. And yeah, I got this last year. And I think I got this from Hobby Lobby. You know, after the Easter sale, how they have the good sales on. And sometimes, you know, not sometimes, all the time I go and See, after the holiday, that's when you get your sale. I went there and picked this up, and Easter was over with, so I saved it. I say, well, I can make this next year, you know. So, and I'm making it now for you guys, doing a tutorial. You know, I always have been nervous to do a tutorial, and it's not that I couldn't do it. It's just, I don't know, things happen when you do a tutorial or anything. Stuff start falling out and just not cooperating right. But I faced that fear head on and said, I can do this, and I'm doing it for you guys. Because you just got to keep going. If things happen, you just got to keep going. Internet mess up, you still got to keep going. Keep staying in it. Finish it out. I'm not gonna cinch it all the way down, but okay, this is what we have. Just one second. I snipped myself. I'll be right back. I'm back, guys. What happened was I had nicked myself earlier, and I didn't want to get no blood on the mesh or anything. So wanted to put a band-aid on that. When I noticed that, I said, "Ooh, let me put a band-aid on this back bleeding again." Not that bad, but it don't take that much. Isn't that cute? Cute bunny. Got something on there, I can get that out. And it's not blood, it's some pink or something on there. It'll be out. Okay, now let me plug up the glue gun, which I should have had on for a while. But so what we're gonna do, I'm gonna put every other in here with the Easter egg. So while the glue gun is warming up, I should have had it on earlier. I'm gonna be, remember, mesh do ravel. That's a given, it's gonna do it. So nothing we can do about that. So I'm just gonna straighten up, and what I'm gonna do is turn down, use this to curl down my tinsel ties. Just bring them all the way down. And the reason why I don't cut them is because, see, I can use this to put my eggs in, and just put the glue in. and keep going with it. I tell you, see, things happen. Remember, I just had spoke of that. I say, this is why I don't like to do, why I was so nervous with doing them, because things happen. And it did, but I wasn't gone long, was I? Hope not, wasn't. I hope you guys enjoying this, because I want to teach, and I love teaching people how to do craft. You know, that's my favorite thing to do. I just get into my zone and just do me. Just create things. I think that is so beautiful. I mean, that's a talent that God gave me, and I want to share it with you guys, if you allow me to. And I hope you guys enjoy them, because there's going to be more to come. More tutorials to come. Because, like I say, I do vinyl projects, designs and stuff, t-shirts. So I will be doing those on there. And do those and get those started up. Well, I got that one messed up. Okay. I need to put some ribbon here. Trying to make sure it was one that was duplicated. And what I can do is put it here. That happens, you can miss them. Trying to figure out where was it duplicated. I guess it's not right here. This is the spot. It still will be. I figured out what I'm gonna do is cut. So I cut another piece of this. 12. Great. Again, we're going to tie down cutting on the sides to get that beautiful shape of V, as in Veronica. I hope you guys had a good day today.